This is Lisa from Mobile Tech Review, and oh my God, it's so hard to find a really nice yet affordable 15-inch multimedia laptop. That's what this is. This is the Lenovo IdeaPad 530S. The IdeaPad line is Lenovo's consumer line, and the ThinkPads are their business line. So this is a 15.6-inch laptop with a $699 price tag, but you've got a CNC milled aluminum chassis on this laptop, Intel 8th generation Ultrabook CPUs, Core i5 and Core i7, a full HD display. And right now, you can get actually the Core i7 with 8 gigs of RAM and a fast PCIe NVMe SSD for $699 on Lenovo's website because they're having a sale. Usually, for that price, you get a Core i5, which brings to mind the point that with Lenovo, they have sales all the time. So if you're interested in their products, always check their website and see what's going on in way of sales. Anyway, it's really solid. It's really affordable. Stoked to look at it now. For a 15-incher, the laptop is very thin and very light. It's under 17 millimeters thick, and it weighs just 3.7 pounds, which is 1.69 kilograms. So you can take it pretty much everywhere. Just throw it in your backpack. Speaking of backpacks, I'd like to thank our sponsor for this video, Level 8, maker of the Atlas backpack that we have here. Level 8 makes backpacks, they make hard shell cases, they even make luggage, and they predominantly market to the MacBook category, but obviously a backpack works for any laptop. And this one's actually pretty nice. I've used it. 3.1 pounds or so, so it's pretty light. It's got a TSA-friendly compartment. Just unzip it, drop it down, and you're ready for inspection. There's good padding on the back as well that breathes nicely, and 3D padding on the inside, so it keeps all your personal belongings safe. It all says compartments, as you would expect, for tablets, for your smartphones, all of your personal belongings. So the 15.6-inch IdeaPad 530S is a pretty significant redesign and upgrade of the 520S, which was a 14-inch laptop that had a hard drive bay inside in addition to the SSD and very low-end NVIDIA-dedicated graphics. This time around, they're just going for that sleek, light 15-inch look. Competes with the Dell Inspiron and with the HP Envy series, the ZenBook to a certain extent. Going for that affordable price tag, but still a classy metal chassis. Something that you might feel a little proud carrying around. So that's a good thing, as long as the internals are up to snuff too. And for the most part, they are. You can get this, like I said, with an Intel Core i5 or i7 Intel 8th generation quad-core CPU. That's a 15-watt Ultrabook CPU. This is not a mobile workstation. This does not compete with the Dell XPS 15 or thin and light gaming laptops. Different category, obviously. It has Intel HD 620 graphics. Now, I've heard tell of NVIDIA MX150, very low-end dedicated graphics, as an option, too. But ours doesn't have it on, and on Lenovo's U.S. website, there is no option for that listed. In your country, maybe you will see that. I don't know. It does have two fans inside, which usually for an Ultrabook you wouldn't see that, so that might be there just in case there was a dedicated GPU. It has 8 gigs of DDR4 RAM, and there is one RAM slot. Of course, I'll show you the internals like I always do, and an M.2 SSD slot. So Lenovo's little special sauce here in this price segment is that it's the faster kind of M.2 SSD. It's PCIe NVMe rather than the SATA 3 kind. So instead of fast, it's fast, you know, like Dell XPS 13 kind of level of fast, which is nice to see in this. Now you can buy with a 256 gig or a 512 gig SSD, or of course you could put your own in after the fact if you wanted to upgrade. It's not too hard to do that. As usual, Intel 8265 AC Wi-Fi with Bluetooth, a 720p, okay, webcam in a perfectly normal position, and huzzah, those thin bezels that are really popular right now, which again, usually you see on the $1,000 and up segment. So you got that kind of classy, borderless, non-distracting kind of look on a laptop in this price point is pretty cool. It has backlit keyboard, two stages of white backlighting. Now, this is a low-travel keyboard, and I'm not real fond of low-travel keyboards, but at least this one has a lot of spring and good key return on it, so it's pretty tactile. So I'll give it a pass for that. There's no number pad on this, so for those of you who hate number pads and offset keyboards, well, you'll be happy. The trackpad is decent, it's serviceable, it behaved well, it didn't make me have fits by doing anything strange or wrong. It's a pretty decent trackpad. It also has a fingerprint scanner embedded on the keyboard deck. Again, that's a nice creature comfort that you don't always see in a laptop in this price range. Port selection on this, you can see it on screen, but one nice thing is it has USB-C Gen 1. At this price, you're not gonna get Thunderbolt 3, alas. Otherwise, pretty happy with it, including the fact that it has an SD card slot and HDMI on board. In terms of performance, this is an Ultrabook 15-watt CPU, so it's great for everyday office kind of work. It's fine for your Photoshop editing, unless you're a professional photographer who's working with high-resolution images day in, day out, then you're going to want a mobile workstation kind of thing. You can do some light video editing with this to, you know, hobbyist level, that sort of thing, and feel pretty good about the speed. It's perfectly fine. The fans come on, and they're a little noisier than average, which is kind of par for the course with Lenovo's IdeaPad series. When they kick in, and sometimes they kick in when you might not expect it, you'll hear them. I mean, they're not the hugest fans. It's not going to drown out the TV in the room, but you'll hear them, and then they usually kick off again. They don't stay on constantly, but not the super quietest laptop out there. Now, one of the drawbacks here is the display. It's not a hideous display. It is a matte display, which is nice. It's a non-touch display, which it's up to you as to whether that's a good thing or not. It is what it is. It's a full HD IPS display, and the color gamut on this is not very wide. In the $1,000 price range, we typically see nearly full sRGB coverage. Here we have 67% instead. So, and not that it looks bad when you look at it, but it's not super colorful. Colors are not going to come alive like they would on a higher-end laptop with a better display. Fair for the price. Again, the contrast on it, everything else is pretty much fine, so it's serviceable enough, just not wow. The brightness also is not super high on this. It's a little bit lower than average, but the reason that you might notice it right away is that the brightness curve is set such that you have to set it to pretty high before it starts to really brighten up. So they're trying to conserve battery power here, which leads into the other, yeah, it's okay, it's not terrible, not great either. It has a 45 watt hour battery. That's on the lower end of normal for a 13-inch Ultrabook. For a 15-inch, you might expect to see more. I know I do. So battery life on this, they claim 8 hours. And you know, manufacturers, PC manufacturers, always have pie in the sky, high claims. So when you see 8 hours instead of double digits, you already know, oh, it's not going to be great. Real life is about 5.5 to 6 hours with moderate kind of productivity use and your usual little photo editing, that kind of work. So not super great. It does do fast charging. It comes with a 65-watt charger to accomplish that versus the usual 45-watt Ultrabook charger. Lenovo bills this as a multimedia laptop, so the speakers on it should be pretty decent, and in fact they are. They're Harman-branded speakers with Dolby Audio, and they're pretty loud, rich, and full. They're pleasant enough, certainly, if you're going to be watching a movie or something like that. Taking out the bottom cover is actually really easy. There's 10 Torx T5 screws. You unscrew them, and then you lift off the top. Using a suction cup makes it a little easier to lift off the top, but nothing difficult. So inside, obviously, the battery. Our speakers here, down firing. Here's our CPU fan, and this is the independent fan over here, and our heat sink, and the Wi-Fi card is right over here, and the RAM is under one of these little fiddly covers right here. One RAM slot, so your maximum is 16 gigs. If you purchase a 16 gig module, you will have single channel RAM because, well, there's not two slots, there is only one slot here, and the M.2 SSD is under this metal cover right over here, another heat shield. So there you have it. You don't have to spend at least $1,000 to get a classy looking Ultrabook with a metal chassis, pretty rigid design, and nice creature comforts. The display, obviously that is where the cost cutting happened here. It could be better. It's not horrendous or anything like that, but you know, it's definitely not what you get when you spend $1,000. But hey, that's kind of fair. The rest of it is all good, and the fast NVMe SSD is a nice little bonus in this price segment. I'm Lisa from Mobile Tech Review. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more cool tech videos, and thumbs up if you like this vid.